As for many world-class universities, our internationalisation approaches are going to have a lot in common with universities around the world. But what's important for all universities around the world, if they're going to successfully internationalise, is to try and negotiate the relationship between the global and the local, to carve out their own distinctive institutional niche. I like to think that's what we're doing at Victoria University. In part, that's because we're very conscious that internationalisation is double-sided. On the one hand, it's about celebrating human diversity, about understanding the very different cultures that human beings have built in different parts of the world. On the other hand, it's also about appreciating our common humanity, because one of the distinctive features of human beings is our ability to cross cultural boundaries. This is especially marked at universities, where we are joined in a common quest for knowledge, so that we know about crossing cultural boundaries. At Victoria, we're proud of our 100-year tradition of academic excellence. We're also proud of living in New Zealand, a tolerant, democratic, multicultural society. That's our foundation for engaging internationally. On the other hand, we're also very aware of a sentiment once expressed by Billy Connolly, the well-known Scottish comedian. If all you are is where you come from, you need to get out more. We're getting out and about. And that is the basis, that is the other basis of our internationalisation. Just like Billy, when we go out and about, though, we're not going to lose our accent, we're not going to lose our values, but we're going to be enriched by that interaction. We think we've got it about right, but we're also open to suggestions from universities around the world, because after all, that's what internationalisation is all about.